ChatGPT's developer mode now boasts full support for what are called MCP tools. This isn't just a small tweak, it means ChatGPT can finally move beyond simply pulling information and start taking real direct actions within your systems. Imagine updating a Jira ticket, triggering a Zapier workflow, or fine-tuning details in your CRM, all without ever leaving your chat window. You can even chain multiple services together, creating a seamless flow of actions. This transformative feature is rolling out in beta for Plus and Pro users. On the web, and setting it up is surprisingly straightforward. Just head into your settings, then connectors, advanced, and flip on developer mode. From there, you can link your own MCP servers, allowing ChatGPT to communicate with them through protocols like SSE and streaming HTTP, complete with robust authentication options if your tools require them. You can even toggle specific tools on or off for each connector and refresh them whenever you update your server, keeping everything perfectly in sync. The truly revolutionary part here is that ChatGPT can now use any tool your connector exposes, not just for fetching or searching, but for full-on write actions. This means how you prompt matters more than ever. If you have overlapping connectors, you'll want to specify the source of truth. If two tools seem similar, be explicit about which one to use. You can even define the exact sequence of operations, telling it to first read a file, then write a modified version back, and ignore everything else. To make this all flow smoothly, the descriptions you write for your tools on the MCP server are crucial. The clearer and more action-oriented those names and notes are, think, use this when you need to update a customer record, the better ChatGPT will select the right action. Because this involves write access, OpenAI has built in significant safety measures. Every tool call will show you the full JSON input and output before anything executes, and write actions always require your approval, unless you specifically choose to let it remember. While prompt injections or model slip-ups are a concern, handled carefully, ChatGPT stops being a passive dashboard and becomes an active control center, running your workflows in real time. Now, let's turn our attention to ByteDance, who just launched their Cream 4.0 image model, clearly targeting Google's Gemini 2.5 flash image, affectionately known as Nano Banana. ByteDance claims Cream 4.0 outperforms Gemini on their internal benchmarks for prompt adherence, alignment, and aesthetics. While we're still awaiting a formal technical report to solidify these claims, the strategic move is undeniable. Cream 4.0 essentially merges the powerful text-to-image capabilities of Cream 3.0 with the robust editing strengths of CDIT 3.0, a combination. Artificial analysis suggests is a significant evolution. Pricing is aggressive too. It maintains Cream 3.0's domestic sticker price, and for global hosting. On platforms like Fault AI, it's approximately 0.03 cents per image, making it slightly more affordable than Gemini 2.5 flash images 0.039 cents. Performance-wise, ByteDance reports raw image inference is over 10 times faster than earlier versions, and early user feedback online has praised its editing accuracy, noting faithful changes from text prompts without distorting the overall composition. While Gemini 2.5 flash image still holds the top spot on public leaderboards for both generation and editing, with Cream 4.0 yet to be scored, the broader AI scene in China is rapidly heating up, with players like Kuaishou and Tencent also in the mix. The government's recognition of copyright for AI-generated content and new mandatory labeling further shape this dynamic landscape. Next, let's talk about Deep Agent, an update that directly impacts creators, freelancers, and small teams where it truly matters, getting paid. The core update is simple to state but massive in its impact. Deep Agent can now generate a fully functional app from a single prompt with Stripe payments seamlessly wired in as a first-class feature. If you've ever wrestled with Stripe integration the old-fashioned way, managing keys, scopes, webhooks, and documentation for hours, you know why this is revolutionary. Here, the agent simply asks you for the essentials. Product. Names, prices, what's included, and it scaffolds the entire thing, handling the checkout process effortlessly. You link your Stripe account in a few secure steps, and from that moment, sales settle directly into your account. No middlemen or duct tape solutions. The sites it produces don't feel like prototypes either. You get a clean build with three practical funnels ready on day one, a product page with visuals and Stripe checkout, a workshop page for bookings and payments, and a consultation page that secures payment before someone lands on your calendar. Updating is just as frictionless. Want to change pricing, add a product, or throw in a discount? Just tell the agent, and the Stripe logic and UI update together. And it's not limited to storefronts. You can prompt for a mini CRM, a Notion-style workspace with permissions, a marketplace, or even a microblog, all with payments baked in. The team behind it is fostering an ecosystem with a weekly human AI build contest, offering significant prizes, and the base tier starts around $10 a month. This capability effectively moves the bottleneck from "Can I build this?" to "Do I have something worth selling?" with working paid apps going live in about half an hour. Moving to the enterprise world, Adobe just made its AI agents generally available across the Experience Cloud. This isn't about hype, it's about delivering tangible value. The core is the Adobe Experience Platform Agent Orchestrator, which uses decision science combined with language models to interpret intent, then activates the right agents to achieve specific business goals. The lineup covers crucial areas like audience building, customer journey orchestration, experimentation analysis, site optimization, data insights, and product support. Crucially, these agents reside within existing Adobe products like Journey Optimizer, Customer Journey Analytics, and the Real-Time CDP, meaning they're plugged directly into the data you're already leveraging within Adobe's ecosystem. Adoption isn't theoretical either. Adobe reports that over 70% of their Experience Cloud customers are already using the AI assistant, the conversational layer that sits behind these agents. Big brands like Hershey, Lenovo, and Wegmans are already on board. The customization story is also rapidly developing, with an agent composer, agent SDK, and agent registry on the horizon, allowing teams to fine-tune agents to adhere to specific brand rules and policies. Adobe has also aligned with key partners to facilitate multi-agent collaboration in complex verticals, promising both compliance overhead management and seamless handoffs. The interesting bit under the hood is their reasoning engine, which enables dynamic adaptive reasoning, so the system doesn't just statically match intents to skills, but adjusts as customer journeys evolve. The consistent pitch, augment teams, boost return on investment, and personalize at scale, all without ripping out your existing workflows. For those already deeply invested in Adobe's ecosystem, these agents aren't an add-on. They are integral to where your campaigns and customer data already live. Finally, let's talk about Claude, as Anthropic just made a highly practical move that many of us need weekly. Claude can now create and edit office-style files directly from natural language and large uploads. Give it some data or a simple request, and it will generate an Excel file, a PowerPoint deck, a Word document, or even a PDF. It can handle substantial files too, up to around 30 megabytes for both upload and download, so you're not constrained by tiny limits. It can convert CSV or TSV data into structured reports, generate charts, and a key feature, perform bulk, context-aware edits without you even needing to open the file. You can instruct it to replace every instance of ABC with XYSD. Convert all USD prices to EUR at a specified rate, or change a role label from manager to executive. Claude then applies these updates while meticulously preserving the original layout. One shot, consistent formatting, no manual cleanup required. While Google's Gemini can also generate documents, for instance, exporting deep research into a Google Doc. The real differentiator here for Claude is the speed and precision of edits on existing files across various formats. There's also a significant signal in the air. Microsoft is reportedly in talks to integrate Claude into the Office 365 suite. If that comes to fruition, Anthropic's powerful editing and creation flow would sit natively inside Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and the rest, transforming Claude into an actual operator within your daily workflow, rather than just another separate browser tab. For anyone wrangling reports, presentations, or financial documents, This means offloading the tedious parts. Context-aware find and replace, currency conversions, role normalization, table fixes, without the risk of breaking your carefully crafted templates. The days of AI being a passive search engine or a mere assistant are rapidly fading. We're entering an era where AI doesn't just inform. It operates, actively shaping our digital world, executing tasks, and bringing ideas to life faster and more seamlessly than ever before. What will you build, create, or automate with this new power? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe and drop a like if you found this update useful. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.